Hello, Malty Malt Brewers. Ralphie here. Welcome to Whisky Review 95. And I'm going to be reviewing three ales which are related in some way to whisky. Now, unless you're in the UK, you're not going to be able to get these. But it's worth reviewing because wherever you are in the world, your availability of little artisan alcohols is increasing significantly. So that you might find, if you're in the United States, that you may get some local or regional or state beers available matured in bourbon casks, rye casks, or Tennessee whiskey casks. If you're in Canada, you may get a local beer matured in a Canadian whiskey cask. If you're in Ireland, why not some of that fine Irish beer in some Jameson's or Cooley casks? If you're in Australia, well, Australians now have more distilleries than the Irish do. Interesting that. But all around the world, people are distilling more. Little distilleries are cropping up all over the place. And these guys have got to be versatile, light in the feet, and be able to offer a range of purchase options in order to get the money coming in, keep the business going. And one of these options is to get a partnership with a local brewer and produce a whiskey infused or a beer matured whiskey or ale. Now, the two options are either beer which has been matured in a whiskey cask or rum cask or brandy or schnapps cask or whatever, or you're going to have an ale which contains some spirit. So it's a fortified ale. And more about that later with my very own whisky ale experiments, which are still in progress. Now, to save a bit of time, I have removed the casks, I've removed the bottle tops. The reason being, this is the second take because I got a bit long-winded and ran on a bit over the time with the first one. So, wish me luck. Introducing Innocent Gun. Let's pour some. 6.6%. This is a strong little ale, and it's matured in fresh wood, American wood casks, which then go on, having had the ale in them, to mature whiskey. They don't specify which one, but I think it's William Grant's blended whiskey, which is ale matured. Not a bad little dram, a little bit different, although if you leave it too long in the glass, it does taste a little bit stale. Here's the blurb you get with the Innocent Gun. It gives you tasting notes, tells you about the awards, and tells you some basically rather implausible little legend about the fact that they were throwing away the beer and then decided to bottle it and sell it for, I was going to say expensive price, but for it's not that, it's not too expensive. But what you've got to watch about with marketing and these peripheral bits and pieces that can come with the bottles is marketing tells you what the manufacturer wants you to know, not what you, the customer, need to know. So get rid of that. Now, second, our little number two here is Paradox. Those bad boy Bam sticks from Brewdog, who produce Punk IPA and other assorted Trashy Blonde, things like that. Kind of fairly fresh approach to brewing, and certainly liven things up a little bit. And one of their ranges is the Paradox, and it includes basically taking a stout or a kind of what they feel is appropriate, an appropriate beer, and maturing it in an ex-whiskey cask. Now, the last time I tried this, it was a Kulila cask, and it worked well because you get a wee bit of peaty hint successfully infused into a stout. But this is Arran cask one, this, and so I've already tasted it, and definitely you get that little citrusy note that one has come to expect with the Arran single malt. Our final candidate is the very rich and dense Hervaston Uldu. Uldu, Gaelic for black oil. It comes with a fancy box and a fancier price. And the feature here is that it's a very rich stout, which has been matured in a 40-year-old Highland Park cask. Having stuck my nose in and had a wee taste to make sure it was good enough to review, which is important, because I don't like to review, I do not review things that I would not buy myself. What I've noticed is that there's a lot of complexity here. I'm definitely quite complex, bit more challenging. There's, you know, this is one that'll take a drop of water, needs time to settle down and open up. Again, it comes with a box. It tells you about Highland Park. It tells you about Uldu, this black oil. Again, just to reiterate, it seems to suit the Scotch whisky industry to use these Gaelic names, which seem unpronounceable, because it does add a certain kudos, a certain, what we call it, classiness, an association with the quality of the whisky, as these obscure names. But there we go. Cardboard box, recycle in the fire, or whatever. Tasting them. I'm not going to mark these. These are an example of what we can get available in the UK, and what you should be looking, wherever you are in the world, you should be looking out locally for some of these little bottled beers that have been produced locally, perhaps infused with herbs, perhaps been matured in your local casks, and they're certainly worth the effort. Malty and citrusy in the nose. There's certainly a kind of dense vanilla and toffee which has come out of the wood and influenced this. It's been matured for 77 days in wood, this ale. This particular one's slightly fresh, but I think it's the time of year. There's high demand when it comes up to public holidays. The paradox is at 10% alcohol, so this is pretty strong stuff. So it might be worth it that you're talking getting towards wine strength. It's maybe add a touch of water just to help shake the flavor chemicals off the alcohol. Aha, now this is quite treacle, toffee, bitter toffee, spicy. There's a spiciness here. And there's a citrus note in the background, a woody citrus. This is an interesting one. Very good. Very dense and heavy when it starts, and yet it finishes quite crisp, relatively light, nice and clean. Lovely, lovely finish in this paradox. The Uldu from Hervison, who also do the magnificent Bitter and Twisted and Schiehallion beers. Very, very thick one, this. If I pour a little from a height, you'll notice you get quite a rich mocha head on it. A very viscous ale, this one, this Hervison Uldu. Challenging in the nose, there's something slightly mossy, fusty, obscurely herbal. Rich, there is a touch of age there. Old bung cloths. Not unpleasant. Again, a very densely toffee, burnt barley ale. It's really a porter. Very dense. It's certainly got range. You do certainly notice the presence of an old whiskey, almost the echoes of it. After the arrival, it just kind of kicks in. They're very interesting and worthwhile if you can get your hands on them. If you can't, as I say, look out for something local. It will be different, but it should be the same. When people are bringing out something into the market for the first time, it hasn't proven itself. The label's new, it's unfamiliar, and therefore they have to concentrate on quality to persuade people to buy it. So it's something to look out for and be aware of. So I'll see you later, and you take care. Safe dramming now.